What's up, guys? Frank here with Matt Tuck from Bullet from a Valentine, who has a forthcoming album dropping on the world in October, and it's the perfect blend of aggressively heavy and accessibly catchy. Matt, it's great to see you, man.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me, man.
Really nailed it. You know, maybe hit an all new stride in your career with this. I mean, at least I feel like it's a very different record for you guys. You know, is that kind of the consensus in the band as well?
Yeah, I think so. We don't think it's anything too different to what the band has been about in the past. You know, we've always delved into kind of the heavier side of stuff occasionally here and there on certain tracks, but we definitely think it's an album that's, you know, it's taken us to the next level of what we do. You know, it's definitely Bullet at its most extreme, but that's great because it feels good, sounds good.
Right off the bat, I think you can tell, like, even from the comments and stuff like that, people are just like talking about how heavy it is. You know, it's kind of like this new breath of aggressiveness in what you do with, you know, mixed with some of that old Bullet flavor that you've always had.
No, it's felt good. It was a really fun record to make. You know, it was definitely something different from Gravity to the last one, which is great. You know, I always like to make sure that, you know, first and foremost, you write from the heart, you write what you want to write, whatever's happening at the moment. You know, you capture it and you go with whatever's coming up naturally. But to have the contrast between the albums is, I think it's really cool. I like it. This was definitely a fun album to make.
And, you know, of course, this is a self-titled album. And when a band releases a self-titled further in their career, it's usually because of something, you know, like they hit a reflection period of some sort, or they set out to create a career-defining moment. Is there a personal story behind this album and, you know, like why it's particularly taken the title of Bullet from a Valentine?
Yeah, just a couple of the reasons you just touched on, really. We just thought that the time was right to kind of put our flag in the sand of who Bullet from a Valentine is right now and what the future is going to look like for us, you know? It's, you know, we really feel that, yeah, we've just come into our own. Just feel like the time is right to go, okay, the history has been really good. We've had great success. We've achieved a lot of amazing things. But it really feels like this album now encapsulates who Bullet really is now. And that's kind of the direction we'll be moving forward from now on. It's very much settled and everything is working very, very smoothly now. So it's good.
And that's, you know, an interesting thing. I mean, considering the world has gone through a pandemic and continues to, really, you know, has that actually helped or hurt the creation of this record?
The creation of it actually helped a lot. It gave us a lot of time to live with demos and songs that we'd written pre-pandemic. It gave us a lot of time to just continue writing during it from January 2020 on, really, when it became clear that things were heading in a bit of a weird direction. So we took it upon ourselves to kind of write as much as possible in 2019, which was, looking back now, you know, a really smart decision. So we'd already got the ball rolling stylistically on where we were going pre-pandemic. So for us then, during that time, it was more living with the demos we'd already done, rewriting, really focusing on who we are, who we wanted to be on this record, and what is Bullet My Valentine, you know, which is, again, going back to the title thing. So the pandemic, it just gave us that time to breathe and to live with it and to really be sure what we were doing. And so, yeah, I there's massive negatives to obviously trying to write and record a record in a pandemic. It wasn't the usual way of doing things, but the creative side of it, it was definitely a positive.
When you say unusual, was that like you had to kind of do it one at a time and not together? Is that what separated it?
Pretty much. Yeah, pretty much. There was a lot of time where I just spent with Carl, our producer, at his place, just because of social distancing rules and laws that were going on here. And just trying to adhere to them and just be sensible, be mindful of what was going on, but obviously trying not to stop the process as well. So there was a big chunk of time where there was nothing going on. And then when restrictions eased, we had to do it in a more stripped down kind of fashion. So yeah, so it didn't, again, it wasn't a negative thing. It was just adapting with what we were allowed to do and not do, I guess. So it wasn't a big deal. We just cracked on and it was great.
And of course, you have been doing this for quite a while now. You know, I mean, it's a large chunk of your life and rightfully so. I mean, any you know, big endeavor should be. What have you really learned about yourself through, you know, doing Bullet from a Valentine for this long?
Just, I don't know if I've learned a ton of stuff. Just, I definitely will look back on it and just be kind of proud that I've stuck to my guns creatively. And I haven't let like outside influence kind of influence my writing. You know, it's, I think you've always got to stay true to what you want to do, really. You can't really go with fashion or trends and stuff. You never do that in the first place, you know. And it's kind of easy to fall into the trap of trying to rewrite successful records as well. It's just not something I've ever been interested in. I just want to take each album as it comes and just go with it. You know, I never force things. I never try and do things for the sake of it. I don't listen to praise or criticism. I just kind of stick to my guns and, you know, just kind of do my thing. So I'm just proud of that, really.
Well, Matt, I know that you're in the middle of this press circuit for the album and going to do 100 interviews. So I figured we'd have a little bit of fun, you know, with the question generator. Do you prefer cassettes, vinyl, or CD?
I prefer CD out of the three. I grew up with cassettes. I grew up with my dad's vinyl, but the convenience of compact discs was that was what I grew up listening to music on. So I just have a bit of a attachment to that.
Do you prefer love songs, hate songs, or fantasy lyrics?
Ooh. Probably love songs. Probably love songs. Yeah. I mean, everyone's a sucker for a good love song, you know. It's I don't know. I like them all though.
If your bus broke down in the middle of nowhere with no cell reception, would you first grab your guitar, your phone, or your pillow?
with no reception, you weren't picking up your cell phone, are you? Probably a guitar. Yeah, probably a guitar. Keep the mind taking over. Get creative. Pass the time.
Do you prefer to be in groups, one-on-one, or alone most of the time?
That's a tough one as well. I don't know, man. I prefer probably in a group. Just for company. I think it's good to have company. It's good to talk rather than be on your own a lot of the time. It's good to be on your own. I do enjoy downtown being on my own, but also, you know, it's good to be amongst people, especially after the last 18 months, you know. It's good realizing the value of interacting with other humans, you know.
Do you prefer Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook?
Maybe Instagram. I don't have Facebook, never had. I haven't used Twitter for years. Post occasionally on Instagram when it's to repost stuff on the band account. I'm not a huge social media user. I've tried, but I just don't know. It's not for me. I kind of do it to repost band stuff most of the time.
Do you prefer making music videos, photo shoots, or doing interviews?
Probably doing interviews. Yeah, because at least there's interaction and communication. The video shoots, the photo shoots, they can be quite long and boring. They probably seem quite glamorous and fun to the outside, but when, you know, they're not at all. They're really boring, and you always end up kind of injuring yourself because you take it too far. Cuts and bruises, sore neck, sore head.
Are you a morning person, night owl, or both?
I'm both, yeah. Depends on what's going on in my life at the time, really. When I'm home and my little one's been at school, definitely morning person. I get into that routine. I like getting up early. I like utilizing the day, using the hours of the day to be kind of good, you know, go to the gym, go shopping, just normal stuff, really. I like being active in the day, using the time wisely.
Are you a comedy, horror, or documentary fan?
Oh man, all three. I love comedy. I love horror. And documentaries has been definitely something which has been useful over the lockdowns to pass the time. Definitely more than movies. So documentaries, if I had to pick one.
Mexican, Italian, or Asian cuisine?
Love them all, but Asians are my go-to if I had the choice.
Yeah, I guess you guys, you did a record out in, what was it, Thailand, was it? Or?
Yeah, we did actually, yeah, back in 2012. Yeah, in Thailand.
Yeah, I remember that.
It was called Karma Sounds, I think it was called. Yeah, beautiful place, amazing studio.
That must have been good eats the whole time, huh?
It was fantastic, yeah. These Thai ladies would come in every day, do lunch and dinner, and do all kind of the Thai special, like prawn dumplings and coconut fried rice, like mango and sticky rice pudding and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that was a good vibe.
Would you rather be smart, successful, or talented?
Definitely smart. Definitely smart. Yeah, I think I think having that one, you can achieve the other two anyways.
Well, Matt, thank you so much for spending some time with me today. Guys, if you haven't yet, pre-order the new Bullet for My Valentine record. Thanks, man. You know, I can't wait to see you guys out there on the road and playing these songs out there.
Cool. Yeah, thanks.